Why does any non-inverter air conditioner require modification? So what happens is that the companies mostly rely on the indoor unit when it comes to 1-ton and 1.5-ton models. And because the larger units have more safety and precautions built in, they usually don't require much modification. But 1-ton and 1.5-ton units often require modification. The reason for this is that sometimes the unit runs 24 hours continuously, which puts a lot of strain on the indoor relay and causes it to get disturbed. And in this circuit, the same thing is happening. It also runs 24 hours continuously. Because of this, the problem here is that its relay has completely broken. Apart from this, if we look at the solder traces on the back side of it and look at its input and output, even this relay has heated up so much that the 12-volt DC supply, which energizes the relay, has also overheated and its tracks are cracked. Because of this, the problem is occurring. Now in this circuit, what we will do is install a new relay and redo the soldering, but in the same way we have another unit here, which is a Mitsubishi unit, and in this case the customer has requested that we modify it in such a way that the system can run for a longer time. Because what often happens is that sometimes the relay works and other times the relay doesn't work. So now in this unit, we will install a contactor, and the very first step is to find a proper space for its installation. You have to carefully look around the entire unit, find the proper space, and then install the contactor there so that the rest of the unit is not disturbed because of it. Now we will begin with its connections. The first thing we will understand is its main connector. In the main connector, here is the L and here is the N, where the main electricity comes into this terminal. And after this, look here, this is 1, this is 2, and this is 3. So number 1 is the line, number 2 is the neutral, and number 3 is the signal, which comes from the indoor unit when the compressor or other components start running. Now, since this is a Japanese system, they normally use the white wire for neutral and the black wire for line. But here, all these connections have been done incorrectly, because here, a white wire is coming to the L terminal, which means someone has made the wrong connections here. So that's why we will also fix these connections. So let's open this connector. These are quite old and dirty, and since they are not according to the company's standards, this is also a doubtful job. On the L terminal, there was a white wire connected, while white should be on number 2. So this confirms that someone has changed it. So now we will change this. Now we will tighten it. And after tightening, we will install it. So now we will connect the white wire here, and we will connect the black wire to terminal 1. Now we will also remove this connection. Now, since we have already installed the connector here, we only need to do the wiring. So all these wires that we have taken out here, we will first connect them into the connector. So this can be attached facing upward as well as downward. I'll open this connector again so that it can be captured properly in the video. So from the wires I removed from the connector, there are two blue wires. One is the compressor's wire and the other is the fan's wire. In the same way, I removed two white wires. One is the fan's wire and the other is the neutral, which goes into the capacitor as well as further to the compressor. So we will connect all these wires into the connector. First, I'll show you how this connector looks from the inside. So let's open the connector. So inside this connector, these pins are fitted, and when we press it, both pins move inward. Whether you choose this side or the other side for input or output, both are the same. There is no difference in it. Now these blue wires, both the fans and the compressors, we will connect here. So I've connected the fan's wire, and this second wire, you can connect it anywhere along with it. So I'll attach the compressor's wire here at the bottom. It should be properly tight. If it's loose, it can cause an issue. Now in the same way, on the other side as well, we'll connect the compressor's wire at the bottom and the fan's wire at the top. So here our connections are ready. Now for the remaining connections that we need to make, we have to prepare some wires. So at this moment, you can see that I have three wires. One is blue in color and two are brown. You need to make sure that the length of these wires is equal. If you make a wire too short, it will cause an issue. So now we have to put terminals on it, and then I will press it. So now our connection is ready. Now these three wires that we prepared, we will connect them with the contactor. We are connecting the brown wire with this blue wire, because this is the line connection. So our connection here is now complete. So now for the blue wire, we will connect the white wire with it. This is our neutral, so we'll connect it here. Now we will connect the third brown wire. This wire is a bit thinner. This will be the signal wire, so we'll connect it at A2. Now the connection is complete here. Now there is one more connection left here, and for that we will make another short wire. Now here is another wire that I have prepared. In this, we will connect one terminal to the A1 connector. Now we will connect the other side of this terminal as well. The connections with this contactor are now complete. Now we will make the connection with its main terminals. So the input we have to give, this one is our main line and the one next to it is the main neutral. So you can give it from anywhere. You can give it from this side as well as from the other side. And this brown wire, I will connect it with the line. The line and neutral are complete. Now the wire that we connected with A2, we have to connect that. So we will connect this wire to the terminal number 3 connection point. So now our connections are complete. Now what will happen is that the main line and neutral will be connected here. And our neutral and phase will come to this point and stand here. Whereas on its A1, the neutral will also be present. Now when we receive a signal from the indoor unit at terminal 3, this relay will turn on. And when the relay turns on, the four points inside the relay will connect with each other, and the whole system will start working. Now I will make this connection, and in this connection I am directly giving electricity. It's not attached to the indoor unit right now. I'll just show you here how it functions. Now we will supply electricity to it. We have turned on the power and now I will show you that electricity is present in it. Now I'm checking its main line, and at this moment we are getting 230 volts. The same 230 volts will also be present on the other side, as you can see. Now let's also check this connector. Look, this connector also has 230 volts present, but our compressor did not start. Now what we will do is turn off the electricity once. Now I have taken an extra wire, and I am attaching it just temporarily to explain to you. So I will connect this wire with the line. And now I will supply electricity to it again. Now electricity has come into it again. What will happen now is that we will attach this with its signal wire, the brown wire, and you will see that our system will start. And look, the fan has also started and the compressor has also started. I am disconnecting the supply because this outdoor unit is completely filled with refrigerant. That's why we won't run it for too long. This was just a method I used to test it, and with this method, the outdoor unit was properly tested, showing that it is working correctly. It will work properly with the indoor unit.